is a very quick demo video of WP Digi Pro. So this is the settings area of WP Digi Pro, and currently I don't have any add-on installed. So first tab, you see all the payment gateways which we are giving away in core version, that is PayPal and to checkout, and we have developers mode also for that your testing purpose. And pages, you set all the pages like successful redirect, after successful payment what will be the redirect page, after failed payment where users will be heading, custom slug, right, and all the page shortcodes for login, dashboard and other pages. And in this email templates area, you set all the emails which will be fired as soon as a particular activity happens. For example, this mail will be sent to admins when one sale is made. And here you see shortcodes which you can use in this particular default body section. In user dashboard section, you can upload logo, your background image. Currently, this will be the default, but you can upload your own logo here, your own background image. Position of menu can be set, right? Currently, it's here, but you can check it horizontal also. And all these button colors, etc. of the dashboard, these can be changed from this tab. Add-ons, all the licenses of paid add-ons will be mentioned here. And in other settings area, you will mention your license renewal policy, its link, the currency. So all these things are in settings area. In reporting, we have all the reporting tools, as in based on product revenues, you can draw the graph, you can have a graphical look, which product is selling better, which is not, right? And similarly, in revenue report, you see daily basis report on what, how many revenues are you generating per day basis, right? And in renew report, you see what all renewals has been happened till date. And in this particular download option, you download all the expired licenses, the email IDs which has expired licenses. In transactions, you see all the transactions which have been made so far. Right, all these tabs will be coming here. What was the payment mode? What was, you know, the email ID of the user, etc. And customers, you manage all your customers, their details, their licensing, etc. If someone has bought, for example, two products, when you click on this name, it will show you what all products they have bought, what are the licenses associated with those products. Similarly, other things. In click tracking, you can create your custom click tracking. For example, if you are running FB ad, right, you can add, create up your custom URL by creating custom this thing by clicking here. You can select a product, or you can create a custom URL. For example, you are directing the whole traffic to your sales page, you can put that URL here, campaign name, source name, and done. One campaign will be created, you can copy this link, and then you can send traffic to that link, and all the links will be tracked. You can create your budget, etc. also here, so that it will show you what is the ROI based on the links. If someone referred by that link buys a product, then that will be added in revenues. This is very useful too. Similarly, in orders, you see all the orders which have been placed so far, right, with the license keys, the dates. It has a search filter. The other filters are also there based on like product. You can filter this. And now these tags, all products add for adding products and, you know, their categories. So in all products, you see all the products which you have been created, right? Whenever you create a product, you see like this, you get a product buy now link, which can be used across your site. For example, I'm using this link on this page, particular page, right? For example, not this one, this one, sample page is the link, right? When you click here, a pop-up will appear. It'll ask for the email ID and it'll be purchased. And this is the powered by Digi Pro link, which you can set in your remove from your settings area. So this is a very useful feature of this plugin, this system, which allows you to, you know, link, share buy now links to any of the web pages of your website. And here you set your pricing option. It is open, whether it's a one time or recurring, right? If it's recurring, then what all the other fields, the first price, then recurring period, the price after first payment, total billing cycles, etc. And here, enable licensing, whether you want to enable licensing or not. If you yes, if you say yes, then how many allowed domains will be there. For example, if it's unlimited, you need mention zero. And if you want this particular product to be used on 10 domains, then maximum 10, then you need to put 10 here. Then license validity, it will be valid for years or months or whatever time. Then deliverables, all these deliverables will be added here. The deliverables which users will be getting in the dashboard area. For example, here, if someone buys one particular product, Jungle Book, then all the download will be listed here with their license keys. And the purchase expiry date will also be coming here. So if the license expired, they will see this renew link. When they click here, they'll be redirected to the renew page, and there they can set for how many time period they want that particular license to be enabled. So this is the feature of WP DigiPro. Here you mention change log, and here redirect settings area, you mention you can create your own funnel basically. After purchase of this product, where the users will be redirected will be mentioned here. Right. So all these things will be here in when you add a product or edit a product. And this is the dashboard area where users will be able to download their products. They'll be, you know, able to manage their account, their password, etc. They'll be doing it from here. They can change the password, they can change their own details. Transaction history will be coming here, and for example, which particular product they have bought and what was the payment mode, invoice number, etc. And this is a logout button, of course. And one more important facility which we have given in this is, for example, if someone buys this particular link, right, and if you want to give them a direct buy now link, then what you need to do is, instead of placing this link here, you can give them a link like this one and just mention hash buy now. So directly they'll be able to buy that product. They'll be able to see that pop-up which comes when they click on this particular link, right? For example, this one, this will be appearing here. So directly they can buy from here. So this is the most beautiful feature of this plugin. Similarly, we have if I show you this edit page, right, we have membership log pages. For example, this particular page will be shown to accessible to the buyers of which particular product. If I select all, then this particular product will be this page will be available to all those users. You just need to add this in the dashboard menu, right? And if you want to available it for like one particular product users, then if someone buys this product, then only this product will be visible. This is the beauty of this feature, page view, I mean locking membership pages. And this is a drift feature. For example, if someone buys a product, then after how long this product will be available. By default it will be available immediately, but if you want that this page should be available then after 7 days, you just mention 7 here, days here, and then only this page will be available, otherwise it will show coming soon. So these are the awesome important features which your WP DigiPro core plugin gives you. Thank you.